And let's talk about this WGH. Look, there's been a lot coming out about this. I was trying to figure out how I was going to structure this whole thing regarding the WGA and now SAG-AFTRA. But then SAG-AFTRA came out and it was just so much. I'm like, my head is spinning trying to keep up with all this stuff, which I'm sure we will be talking about this for weeks to come. So I'm not going to really go and spend like 30 minutes talking about it. But one of the things that disturbed me was when I got this screenshot in the group chat, which irked the shit out of me. So Deadline did an article called Hollywood Studios WGA Strike Endgame is to let writers go broke before resuming talks in the fall. And this is what they said. They said to do so, the studios and the AMPTP believe that by October, most writers will be running out of money after 5 months on the picket lines and no work. The end game is to allow things to drag on until union members start losing their apartments and losing their houses, a studio executive told Deadline. Acknowledging the cold as ice approach, several other sources reiterated the statement. One insider called it a cruel but necessary evil. Really? So people losing their homes and going home and being homeless and losing everything, that's a cruel but necessary evil for who exactly? For you? Because I keep saying, without writers, y'all don't have a script. Without a script, you don't have actors who can act out what is on the page. Look, as Thelma Hopkins said in an episode of Family Matters, if it ain't on the page, it ain't on the stage. So I don't understand why these people think that that Hollywood could survive without writers. And I don't believe in that. It's not what you deserve. It's what you negotiate. That's some fucking bullshit. The fact of the matter is, writers, actors, a lot of them, they're part of a union. So their union reps or their agents, whatever the case is, they're the ones who go in and negotiate. Performers never go in and negotiate their own shit unless you're acting as your own manager and agent and independent. But for the most part, they have people that do that on their behalf. And sometimes, who knows, these agents could probably be lowballing and being like, oh, so-and-so said that this is the number, you should go with this, and then eventually you'll get this. But for the most part, I do believe that the reason why a lot of the writers are going on strike is because it's streaming. They want residuals for the streaming. And a lot of it, Netflix, all these other streaming services are playing hardball. But I think also, maybe, who knows, writers need to get more realistic and realize that, you know what? Streaming is still a relatively new thing. The studios need to figure out how to make the whole thing work in regards of how do we divide this money made from streaming. I don't think they figured that out yet. They go by numbers and algorithms and all this other shit, like how many hours watched. Like whenever I come on here and I talk about, oh, this movie did really well on Netflix because they accumulate how many hours were watched. I'm like, but what if I only watched 10 minutes? Or what if people didn't really watch the whole movie? They only watched part of it. Or like 5 minutes, or 10 minutes, or 15 minutes, or 20 minutes, or 30 minutes. Like, you're accumulating that as hours watched. So that's what they're counting. And then on top of that, it's like, okay, with writers and actors and then a third, how do you pay them in residuals? So they need to figure all that out, because it's easy to navigate that when, you know, if you do video on demand, you have to order and you have to pretty much pay for that in order to see it. So that way they could accumulate the money there because they see that someone has purchased that. Same thing when you watch shows on television, where they have the commercials and sponsors and all that other stuff. They could accumulate things that way. When you buy a box set for a movie, that's, you know, something that was bought. So they can accumulate that. But they haven't figured out a way to accumulate how to pay artists, writers, actors, that sort of thing through the streaming. So they need to figure that out. And so basically they just want everybody to just go broke and be like, you know what, come back with their tail between their legs. Oh, sorry, we made a mistake. So therefore, we want to come crawling back and take whatever scraps you give us. Hell fucking no. And then Bob Iger, child, I was so glad he was coming back to Disney, you know, as a CEO, because Bob Chapek then sat and fucked up the thing. And now they just basically got Bob Iger coming back, and they just recently announced that 2026 is how long he'll be there. So they need him to stay 3 more years to get Disney back up and running after the mess that they turned that shit into. So they said during an appearance on CNBC's Squawk Box, and then before, after that, then we're going to talk about the actor strike, because this is the writer strike and the actor strike. And we got a clip of Fran Drescher, who is the CEO of SAG-AFTRA. She came out and she went ham on the industry over their bullshit. So, it said during an appearance of CNBC's Squawk Box on Thursday morning, Disney CEO Bob Iger said that the writers and actors unions going on strike in Hollywood are not being realistic with their expectations. Speaking with CNBC's David Faber from the Sun Valley Conference in Idaho, Iger commented on the ongoing Writers Guild of America strike and the imminent decision for SAG-AFTRA to join them. It's very disturbing to me. We've talked about disruptive forces on this business and all the changes we're facing. The recovery from COVID, which is ongoing, it's not completely back. This is the worst time in the world to add to that disruption. I understand any labor organization's desire to work on behalf of its members to get the most compensation and to be compensated fairly based on the value that they deliver. We managed as an industry to negotiate a very good deal with the Directors Guild that reflects the value that the directors contribute to this great business. We want to do the same thing with the writers, and we like to do the same thing with the actors. There's a level of expectation that they have that is just not realistic, and they're adding to the set of the challenges that this business is already facing, as is, quite frankly, very disruptive. So what is the level of expectations that y'all think that they're, that's not realistic? Because I'm saying, if there's no way for you guys to give them money off the back end, like residuals of this editor, which you get way more residuals if you write for network television instead of they can accumulate all that. But then when you do a show for, say, Netflix, you get a $4 check or something. Like, I've heard the stories. Why not just give them money up front? Give them bigger writer's rooms. That's what they want. They don't want to be in a walk-in closet cramming two people in there and writing a 10-episode series. They want 6 to 7 writers. Pay them the money that you want to pay them and have them help and do what needs to be done. And then at this point, then y'all need to really sit down as corporations, CEOs, whatever the case may be, and figure out how you're going to pay these artists in residuals. Because what I don't understand is how the hell y'all got money to be paying, you know, these CEOs like a Bob Iger and a Bob Chapek. How can y'all, you know, a pay package, like I said, in 2022, Iger's total pay package was $15 million. Though Chapek was paid $24.5 million, was at the helm for the majority of last year. After Iger took over again, it was revealed that he has the potential to earn up to $27 million in 2023. His first full year as return CEO. So CEOs can bag $24.5 million. CEOs can give themselves $100 million in kickbacks, but y'all can't find the money to pay people. It's the same shit that's going on with the Ukraine. Oh, y'all can find billions of dollars to send to them motherfuckers that want to deny black people getting out of the Ukraine because of all the bombings that was going on. Let's not, you know, act brand new with that. Y'all could be racist towards people of color, but Biden can find money to send billions of dollars to them, but y'all can't find money for reparation. It's funny y'all, how y'all can find the money when y'all need to. So now we're at a point where actors have officially gone on strike today. I believe Oppenheimer is doing their press run. I just heard Matt Damon and that entire cast walked off the red carpet because once it became official that the writer's strike was going on, you cannot appear at any red carpets. You cannot do any kind of interviews. You cannot do auditions. Nothing related to the industry. You can't do voiceover work. Can't do nothing. So they're all at a standstill right now. And they basically said that the failed negotiations with the Alliance of Motion Picture and Television Producers means film and television productions will immediately halt, essentially shutting down Hollywood. So Hollywood is at a standstill right now. And they said that SAG-AFTRA will join up with more than 11,000 already striking film and television writers. So, everybody's on the picket line, and this is the first time that we've had a strike in the industry since 1960. Isn't it the same year that West Side Story came out? Bob Iger was trying to retire. I'm reading Sailor Mermaid's thing. Look, Bob Iger was trying to retire, but Bob Chapek done fucked up Disney. Disney abruptly fired him, and they needed somebody to come up in there and clean up the mess. Once he, you know, they find a viable replacement in 2026, then he'll be able to come in and do whatever. But unfortunately, this is what's happening right now. They don't have many, I guess, CEO they trust to take over, that has the tenacity to take over and keep a business afloat. But anyway, let's get to this clip of Fran Drescher, and then we will come back with more of my opinion on this whole situation. So roll the clip.
You have to wake up and smell the coffee. We are labor and we stand tall and we demand respect and to be honored for our contribution. You share the wealth because you cannot exist without us. Thank you.
I mean, she's absolutely right. It's like, you cannot, Hollywood cannot function without actors. They cannot function without writers. And they're sitting there like these CEOs, and it's like, you need to see the whole interview. I mean, the whole speech. It's like 6+ minutes. I do have the full speech on my Twitter. I basically, I basically retweeted it. So it's there. And I do agree with, she said, how they plead poverty when they are losing money left and right, when they give $100 million to their CEOs. If we don't stand tall right now, we are all going to be in jeopardy of being replaced by machines. And that was basically the fear that they had. It's funny how, like, it was very timely, because that was the kind of the same thing they were talking about in the new Mission Impossible movie. I know people were getting on Fran because she was spotted early in the week in Italy with Kim Kardashian. It was probably just a damn photo op. But of course, because people hate Kim so damn much, and she got dragged not too long ago because she was popping up on 57th Street to shoot another tight ass season of American Horror Story, which, don't even get me started on Ryan Murphy's tight ass bitching about the fact that, you know, he's got a bunch of projects on the horizon and nothing can get done because of a strike. Well, I guess we're going to be flooded with a bunch of damn reality shows. So, I say all that to say, I stand with, you know, the writers. I did see there was, I guess I didn't, oh yeah, I did. So, apparently they said that, to conclude with this, because who posted it? Trying to stall while it opens. Deadline says House of the Dragon and industry will continue UK shoots despite SAG after strike. So while everything else is striking, there's some of the shows are still going, you know, as planned. And here's what they said. House of Dragon and industry are set to continue shooting in the UK this summer despite the SAG after strike. Though a U.S. program, Game of Thrones prequel House of the Dragon has a largely British cast working under equity contracts rather than SAG-AFTRA ones. Similarly, fellow HBO show Industry operates under equity rules, and sources close to production say that both shows are moving forward as planned. U.S. actors Mahela Harold and Ken Leung are key cast members in Industry, which is co-production with the BBC. Guidance issued in the past hour informed SAG-AFTRA members working under equity contracts that they should continue to work, to report to work. Whether the cast of the show would want to work under the current conditions isn't known, but the UK has strict anti-trade union laws that do not allow for members to strike in unity with other counterparts in other countries. Industrial relations legislation in the United Kingdom is draconian and often viewed as the most restrictive in the Western world. The convoluted and pernicious hurdles faced by all unions in the United Kingdom are a national disgrace and need urgent reform. The regrettable consequences of this framework is what artists working on in the United Kingdom, whether SAG-AFTRA and or equity members or both, can do may be different from their comrades in the United States or other parts of the world. So I don't know. It's just, this is absolutely insane the way some of these countries work with their whole idea of, you know, operations. I don't know. It's just, it's batshit crazy to me. I'm like, oh, I thought I was getting a phone call. But anyway, to me, it's just batshit crazy. It's so much to unpack. I don't even know. I need to read more on the British law and their whole union and all this stuff. I don't want to really give my opinion on that just yet because I just read that and it's going to probably take me a minute to process. And I don't want to just say a bunch of stuff if I don't have the education and the information to back up my thoughts. So,